As a parent or a student, almost everybody who has spent enough time in India would agree that the country needs to do a lot more to match the highest global standards in its overall education infrastructure. Experts think that India's National Education Policy 2020 appears to be a step in the right direction. But before we dig deeper, let's compare how an average school in an Indian village looks compared to a school in a European village. So this is a small village in Poland. It is a government-run school providing free education. Decent infrastructure, well-qualified teachers, digital education, well-equipped science labs and other modern amenities and sports facilities are just a standard norm. Now compare this to the average government-run village school in India. The less said, the better. The uncomfortable truth is that in terms of overall quality, the average government school in a Polish village would even beat many expensive private schools in India. And when it comes to higher education, if we put aside some of India's top institutions, the situation should be more or less the same. Now, it doesn't mean that India hasn't produced some world's top brains, and also it doesn't mean that one should underestimate the capabilities of the top Indian universities. What I mean to say is that in broad terms, India's potential is underutilized, and India needs to build an education infrastructure that matches its global ambitions. As a parent whose child is going to study in India, I am personally looking at the National Education Policy 2020 with a lot of anticipation and hope. So, the new policy aims for universalization of education from preschool to secondary level with 100% GER in school education by 2030. It also talks about a new 5+3+3+4 school curriculum with 12 years of schooling and 3 years of preschooling. And very importantly, teaching up to at least grade 5 will be done in mother tongue or regional language. Massive transformation is also expected in higher education, as the gross enrollment ratio will be raised to 50% by 2035. The curriculum will have flexibility of subjects and multiple entry or exit options will be given. The official statement from the Indian government says this: UG education can be of 3 or 4 years with multiple exit options and appropriate certification within this period. For example, certificate after 1 year, advanced diploma after 2 years, bachelor's degree after 3 years, and bachelor's with research after 4 years. In order to improve the overall research culture, National Research Foundation will be established. Very importantly, focus is also on teacher education, which is something that India needs desperately. Besides that, financial support for students is expected to help the underprivileged sections, and online education and distance learning should also improve the GER. The press release also mentions that the center and the states will work together to increase the public investment in the education sector to reach 6% of GDP at the earliest. This is a very important step, as one can see that in 2016, among BRICS economies, India's public education spending as a percentage of GDP was the lowest. The release of NEP 2020 has started a series of debates and discussions in India, and many prominent personalities have begun to share their feedback and opinions. The director of IIT Kharagpur writes, "The emphasis on primary education in regional languages and the introduction of Sanskrit following the three-language formula will turn out to be a great boon to the people of the country, especially in the rural areas." In several European universities, Sanskrit is being explored as a coveted academic discipline. German universities have delved into Sanskrit learning to research on the scientific heritage of the Vedas, Upanishads, and other ancient Indian scriptures such as Bodayana Sutras, which contains mathematical principles of square roots, Pythagorean theorem, geometric principles, etc., or Pingala's Misrao Cha, which is usually identified as the Fibonacci number series, and works on advanced mathematics, physics, astronomy, chemistry, metallurgy, and much more. He adds, "India in this 21st century still has much left to look back and explore our hidden wealth. Endowing our student community with an evolved language like Sanskrit will help shape a rational thought process among school-going children. The regional and Sanskrit language education will also enable our student community to grow strong indigenous roots and learn from the resources of our rich heritage, while training in computer programming will upskill them to dive for more opportunities as the 21st century progresses. According to Malavika Sarkar, academic bank of credit to digitally store academic credits will go a long way in providing a favorable environment to students to plan their education. According to Mahadeo Jaswal, allowing global institutes to set up campuses in India is also a positive move, as it will increase competition because it will open up our education system, and it will also help sustain high talent in the country, as students don't have to move out to pursue education. According to Sridhar Rajgopalan, education should be in mother tongue or local language at least till class 5, after which should be in English. This approach has a lot of benefits. He adds, pedagogical research has established beyond much doubt that children learn best if they learn in their mother tongue in the primary classes. I think that in the long term, this change in India's education policy can even have a global impact. How India shapes its youth and how India equips them with skills will define India's position on the world stage and impact the international trade, technology transactions, and international geopolitics. Today's students are tomorrow's professionals. Considering India's massive share of the global working-age population, this change in India's education policy can easily be regarded as a significant global development. And by the way, if you are keen to learn more regarding India's scientific output, I highly recommend this episode. See you again!